at 4 o'clock in the afternoon of November 30th, 1864. Carnton Plantation was witnesses in one of the most bloodiest battles of the entire Civil War. The Confederate Army of Tennessee furiously assaulted Union troops, dug into along the southern edge of Franklin. The Battle of Franklin was the bloodiest 5 hours of combat during the Civil War. Although it was short in duration, some 8,500 soldiers were killed. Nearly 7,000 of that number were Confederate. The Carnton Plantation, owned by Franklin residents John and Carrie McGavick, turned out to be the largest field hospital in all of Franklin. It was there that this heroic couple tended to many wounded and dying soldiers. I'm here at the Carnton Plantation in Franklin, Tennessee. This house was owned by John McGavick and his wife. They used it to hospital many Confederate soldiers in the Army of the Civil War. I'm here on the back porch of the Carnton Plantation. After a soldier died inside, the doctors would bring him out on this porch and lay him down. Eventually, this whole porch was laid down with dead bodies of soldiers during the Civil War. Right now, I am standing in front of the slave quarters of the Carnton Plantation. Come on, let's go inside. As you can see, they are very small quarters. As you can see, many of them had to sleep on the floor. That is not good. In 1864, one of the soldiers wrote a letter to his wife.
Dear Ellie Mae, the wounded in hundreds were brought to the house during the battle, and all the night after. And when the noble old house could hold no more, the yard was appropriated until the wounded and dead filled that.
I am a few hundred yards away from the Carnton House. Following after the Civil War, John McGavick took all the Confederate dead bodies and buried them here in his private cemetery. 8,500 Union and Confederate soldiers died that day. 1,400, almost 1,500 Confederate soldiers were buried here. One of them is J.C. Simmons. But for many others, no one knew their names. Unknown. And that's just a few of them. Right here lays the graves of John and Carrie McGavick. Inside their own mansion, they tended wounds of many Confederate soldiers. The Battle of Franklin was one of the bloodiest battles in all of the Civil War. John and Carrie McGavick, even though they didn't even raise one single weapon, they are some of the battle's truest heroes. They will never be forgotten.